it's in the well-lit room.
Excuse me?
What you need to drive the darkness back. The well-lit room is at the dam. I built the room to keep it safe.
Stuck up here.
Will it help me find Alice? Will it get me back to the cabin? Fine, let's go. I can get my friends to come back with the helicopter.
Oh, we won't go outside. Never at night. That's rule number one. You've been breaking the rules, young man, and where has that gotten us, hmm? Oh, I have a secret route, a lit route, an old water pipe. Something was damaged at the transformer yard. It's draining all the reserve power. Without it, the pipe will go dark. The power to the yard must be cut.
Let me guess. You want me to do it?
Young man, you're the one who likes to break the rules. I can't be outside in the dark. The kill switch is outside.
All right, then. Pick up the thermos. Another dude.
Weaver had sent me to cut the power to the transformer yard. I was willing to do grunt work for her to get her to help me. I hoped Weaver was dependable. I'd stumbled into this crazy world a little over a week ago. She had been living this insanity for decades. I could see the kill switch that would cut the power to the transformer yard. Now I had to find a way to reach it.
Gladly take some shotgun ammo.
Who designs these things? The transformer yard went dark and dead. Weaver's water pipe passage should now be good to go. Thank you.
Oh, fuck. Wrong way. I'm dangerously low on ammo. It's not anything in here, is it?
This way, young man. Follow me. Come, the pipe's empty now. We're ready to go.
Oh, I forgot I have a flare gun.
This way. We need to go. I knew them both, Tom and Barbara. I had such a crush on him. Such a beautiful man. I was jealous. There was a part of me that was maybe a little glad when she had the accident. And then Tom started writing and woke the darkness up. He tried to bring her back, but you can't do that. There are no free rides like that.
I'm starting to realize that.
In that case, young man, perhaps you're a smarter man than Tom was. Witch looked like her, but it wasn't. Barbara was sweet. He didn't understand until it was too late. He tried to undo it, wrote himself, her, everything he'd ever written out of the world. He was so famous. And afterward, no one knew. Oh, Tom. He left only one thing behind in my game, in case it happened again. Insurance. He trusted me. Or perhaps used me a little. Tom knew how I felt. Knew I wouldn't refuse him. I built the well-lit room and put it there. It's been waiting for you. We are characters trapped in a story you have. And none of us will survive to see the end of it if the darkness isn't stopped. She'll twist the story to her own dark ends.
How do you know all this?
Tom, that's the way he wrote it. He still talks to me, you know, in the television, from beyond, from below. We have both been touched by the darkness, young man. He saved us both with light, but the darkness stays with you. Use a stain. This pipe will take us directly to the well-lit room.
Okay, I need to call my friends, tell them where we're going.
Hello? Ow!
Barry, we're headed to the dam in one of the pipes. Meet us there.
Okay, I'll tell Sarah.
It's Sarah now?
Whoa! No! Sweet love of...
Barry! Barry! We gotta go see if they're okay.
They're probably dead. You must reach the well-lit room. This is no time to be a selfish idiot.
That's my best friend!
Well, be a fool. I'll use the pipe. I'll meet you at the dam if you make it.
At least I didn't have to worry about her. She knew how to stay safe.
True. Thank you. Keep pressing the wrong button.
Site looked bad, but as far as I could tell, the wreck was empty.
Kid.
I have a different ending in mind.
Yeah, I'm fine. Thanks for asking.
I knew you'd be all right.
How's that?
The Flaming Eye of Mordor?
Laugh it up, funny man. Then we have somewhere to go.
Weaver will meet us at the dam.
I really wants me to have this hunting rifle. Fuck it, let's do it.
Most of your night running uphill while a crazy bunch of demon hicks try to take your head off with an axe. You know your helicopter crash landed in Night Springs.
Ooh, I should've
see those lights? That's the elevator we need to take.
Was that it? Are we safe?
That was... wow. I think we're okay.
Hey, Al, I got a bad feeling.
Let's keep our eyes open.
Oh! We made it! We're not dead!
Wake, call the elevator! I'm keeping watch.
I think I hear something moving around.
Coming! We have to hold them off!
Oh, no.
Wait, call the elevator. I'm keeping watch.
I think I hear something moving around.
Almost there. There's an entrance into the dam at the top. What's the plan, Wade?
Well, Weaver's crazy, but she's got something Zane left behind. Something to fix this.
Gee, could you be a little more vague?
Thomas? Zane? Seriously? Might as well be Paul Bunyan or Bigfoot.
Yeah, well, he was real.
Let's be careful, okay?
Yes, let's.
Oh, geez, I hate this.
Okay, wait. There's a button over there that opens the door. I think something's broken. Hold the button down so we can get in.
Should be in the dam now. I'll have to make it alone through the top.
Okay, wait. Good luck. Don't get yourself killed.
Ah, please be careful.
I'll take quick care of Barry, Wade. You just look after yourself.
You gotta be kidding me.
Thank you.
Alright, to the well-lit room. Onward.
Ridiculously outnumbered. The searchlight could even the odds.
No further.
Uh-oh.
Stop. Stop now. Make and model.
Right.
There's an old army base at Raincove Point, north of here. It was active during the Second World War. They operated here back then. They must have built this.
Yes, they did. It's my place now. Take it, and I won't need to worry about the room anymore. more, because 6 and 33 and 118 need changing soon, and I don't want to climb up the ladder to change them because it's very late and I'm tired. And if you take it, I won't have to do that anymore.
The page was autobiographical, a memory from my childhood. But I didn't write this. It was a page written by Thomas Zane. None of them were supposed to exist anymore.
Alan, 7 years old, would fight sleep to the bitter end. When he did sleep, he soon woke up, screaming, the nightmares fresh in his mind. One evening, his mother, sitting by his bed, offered him an old light switch. She called it the clicker, and flicking the switch would turn on a magical light that would drive the beast away. To imbue the talisman with all possible power, she added that it had been given to her by Alan's father. Alan never knew him, and anything of his took on mythical proportions in his mind. With the clicker firmly in his hand, Alan finally slept like a baby. Now, almost 30 years later, Alan thought of this as he stood on the rim of Cauldron Lake, the clicker in his hand. He took a deep breath and jumped.
My mind swirled. I'd given the clicker to Alice, yet it was here. Zane had written it into existence in a story I had written.
What?
I can get to her now. I can finish this.
It's like story inception.
Do you remember standing on a broken field? White crippled wings beat in the sky.
Alright, I'm gonna go to the bathroom and get another drink. I'll be right back.
With the nature revealed and our chances flowing by. If I can let
Previously on Alan Wake, I wrote a horror story that has come true. Thomas Zane did the same in the 70s.
You will go no further.
If I continue like the Dark Presence wants me to, the story I'm writing won't save Alice. It's a horror story. No one will survive.
You knew Zane! Thomas Zane! You're the Lady of the Light in the song!
He left something behind to help me. The clicker.
Alan thought of this as he stood on the rim of Cauldron Lake, the clicker in his hand. He took a deep breath and jumped.
I can get to her now. I can finish this. Was about to explode and the light hurt my eyes. I needed my sunglasses and painkillers to dull the pain. In one of my finer moments of self-deception, I swore to quit drinking. Ugh. The sunglasses made the world look bearable. Now I could keep my eyes open without feeling like a vampire in the sun. Pills worked fast. The prospect of being awake started to seem bearable again. There was a message waiting for me on the machine.
You have one new message.
Ow! Are you still asleep? Wakey, wakey! You should have your show on your TiVo. If Alice wasn't too mad to record it, that she called me earlier and really chewed me out. Yeah, yeah, we went a little doing your career any favors by trying to run your life like that, okay? I'll talk to you later, Al. Watch the show!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Harry Garrett Show.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. We have a great show tonight. I've been talking with the best-selling author, Alan Wake, about his new book, The Sudden Stop. Yeah, good read. Go buy it. No, it is a good read. Look, I'm going to be honest here.
Is that wise?
No, but I'm going to do it anyway. I got people who give me the lowdown on books. I'm a busy guy. But this one, I actually read from cover to cover. I mean, I'm a big fan.
Wow, thanks.
Yeah, that's a little horseshit. Done with it.
Hey, honey. Did you watch the show?
I didn't say anything stupid, if that's what you want to know.
Okay, Grumpy. You want an aspirin or something?
Are you going to start with me about drinking now?
You know what? Go back to sleep, Alan.
What? Now you can't even talk to me?
Well, this morning I was angry because you said you'd be home at midnight and you showed up at 7 a.m. and passed out in mid-sentence. Now I'm over it. Are you angry?
This goddamn tour. It's gotten out of hand.
Oh, honey. It's almost over, right? We can get back to normal. Then you can start writing again.
I'm sorry, honey.
Alan, you're not thinking straight. Just take a shower and go back to bed, huh?
Yeah, you're right, honey. I'm sorry. Once this is over, let's go away together. A vacation. Just you and me. Some peace and quiet. Somehow, the clicker was the key to the cabin. I had to return to Cauldron Lake to save Alice. I'm going back to the lake to finish this. I'm going to write an ending to the story in the manuscript on my own terms, to make it all right.
Why can't you just write it here?
The last page is still in the typewriter. I need to read it first. Everything needs to be just right. Zane tried to cut some corners, and it didn't end well.
Okay, ready when you are.
I'm sorry, Sarah, but I need to do this alone. Barry, take her gun. Miss Weaver, close the door when I leave.
Good luck, Al.
See you later.
Sheriff doesn't seem too pissed about someone taking her gun.
When I got out, it was warm and sunny. I'd flicked the switch of the clicker. Had it done this? I didn't stop to question it. I had to take advantage of the sunlight to get to the lake. On Zane's page, I'd stood on the rim of Cauldron Lake, about to use the clicker. That's where I was headed. Surrounded by the beauty of the Pacific Northwest landscape, it was hard not to let doubt creep in one last time. I could still chalk everything up to a dream, a delusion. I had enough imagination to make up something like this, having been in the cabin all this time, trapped in a story inside my head, gone mad from grief over Alice's death like Hartman had claimed. There would be no way of knowing. I told myself it didn't really matter. My course was set.
Of course.
The darkness had touched me. There was a link between us, always would be. I could feel its presence again, getting closer.
Happens to be a car there with the keys in the engine. Ready for me to go. Ran straight into that one, didn't I?
Thank you.
God bless. This sucks. What the fuck? This is some bullshit right here.
Thank you.
flashback. It's my favorite. Bangs. Flare gun's always nice. This looks dangerous. Please tell me I'm almost there. I've gotta be almost there, right? Thank you.
told Barry my plan back in the well-lit room. I'd acted as if I knew what I was doing. I didn't. I was operating on the shifting logic of a dream. I had to fight my way to the lake through the horrors of the night. I had to flick an old battered light switch imbued with childhood magic. I had to write a happy ending to a horror story. I had to save my wife from the dark prison she was being held in.
I will never give her to you.
Haha. Sucks to suck. Okay.
I can see Mirror Peak in the distance. That's where Cauldron Lake was.
So I've still got a ways to go, huh? Great. Checkpoint there. Really hope we're close.
Damn.
Hey. Yeah, we're like right at the end. Like right at the end. They are really fast. Now I'm lost. Where the fuck am I? Like I've lost track of the trail. Gotta make it to the lake, and it'll all be over. And then we can start our marathon. Okay, fucking hell. That is a boat. not see that up here. Oh, man. This game stresses me out. Flashbang's my favorite. Nothing up here. Oh, wait, yes, there's. I think I gotta go this way. Shotgun ammo. Put it on shotgun.
I needed to get the generator running.
And there it is. And I'm about to get attacked. Good thing the flare gun is like the best thing in the game. Oh yeah, is that right? Fast dudes. So annoying. Oh. Please tell me mom's there.
Turn back now.
No. Thank you. That seems dangerous. Do we have to go that way? How do we destroy this tornado? Gotta be almost there, right?
Into its heart to hurt it.
Okay, so I'm not actually doing it. Excuse me. Belly flop!
Hell!
Shh, baby. You were having a bad dream. It was just another nightmare.
No, it wasn't.
No.
Everything's fine. You're
no.
home.
It wasn't a dream.
Everything's fine.
Turn the lights on. Turn the lights on!
Shh, baby. The power's out. There's no light. Come back to bed and I'll make you forget all about your fear in the dark.
Fear? It's your fear. Why aren't you afraid?
You're not Alice. Turn the lights on now. Where's the clicker? What did you do with it?
Alan, you're scaring me now. Come back to bed. Have you taken your pills? Do you want me to call Dr. Hartman? Come back to bed, Alan.
Come back to bed, Tom.
I read your manuscript. It's brilliant. Departure is your best work. You're a genius. I'm so proud of you. Come.
I know, right? Thomas Zane.
You must find your way to the cabin. It stands in your way. It won't let you pass. It has no heart. It's filled with darkness. You must fill its heart with light. Don't mind him. He's Mr. Shaw. Your friends will meet him when you're gone. Use the clicker.
The fuck is Mr. Scratch?
I'm leaving you.
What?
I'm leaving you, Alan. I met someone. I'm in love with someone else.
Alice? No, what do you say? You can't...
You don't love me. How could you? You don't even love yourself. All you do is torture yourself with work you can't do anymore.
No, I love you more than anything in the world. You're my muse.
I'm not.
Who are you? What have you done with my Alice?
Wasn't true. Nothing like that had ever happened.
You're not my Barbara.
Tom, let me go. I promise to be good. Please, untie me, you naughty boy.
I will help
you write your masterpiece. I will love you forever.
No, you're not Barbara Jagger. I made a terrible mistake. I should have never...
Now you will never get her back.
Oh. She's got a big old hole in her chest.
I am much older than you. Older than your first work of art. I will find a new face to wear. Someone else to dream me free.
I could feel Alice's presence close by. I understood what I had to do now. I knew how to write the ending to Departure. There's light and there's darkness. Cause and effect. There's guilt and there's atonement. But the scales always need to balance. Everything has a price. That's where Zane had gone wrong. There's a long journey through the night back into the light.
No!
Yeah, that cutscene definitely showed this game's age. Definitely showed this game's age. Like, this was like, you know, 360 era game. And like, sometimes the cutscenes look more like Xbox PS2 era. It was very rough.